Good morning, friends and fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market prep video for August 18th, 2023. Well, doggone it, yesterday those bears had a little bit more to say, pushing things down. What does that mean for today? Well, how about we settle in? Let's buckle up. Let's get ready for the Friday edition of the morning market prep video. Good morning once again, everyone, and thank you so much for being here. I do really, really appreciate it. Let's take a look at these charts and see if we can figure out how we might want to approach the market for today. Well, as I mentioned yesterday, that 50-day moving average on the diamonds, I said once we start getting close to that, prices tend to, it tends to pull the indexes down, and this was the last of our indexes to test the 50-day moving average. And this morning we're moving on lower. And one of the reasons we have some ugly news out of China, Evergrande, one of their largest property developers, is filing for bankruptcy. Hong Kong has sold off into bear territory. And the issues over there in China's property situation just continues to get worse, with more than one developer in a very serious situation going on over there, as that economy continues to contract and is likely into a deflationary cycle. So that is putting a little bit of a bearish look on the market this morning already. Let's take a look here. If we look at our ideas of support resistance in the chart, if the bears were to continue to push, by the way, you notice that we've tested this fairly significant level of price support in the chart. And if I were to, that's showing this level right in here. If I were to suggest another level lower, maybe we push down in here, right in here, just a tiny little bit lower. You can see all these high points right through here. We might test that yet this morning or today in a pushback here to test the trend of the diamonds if the bears continue to find inspiration to sell. If the bulls were to come in and work to reverse this market, and there's reason that that could be the case, then we would look right in here for the first test of resistance in the chart to see if we can bounce back up through there. If they can get through that level, I'm going to suggest this area right in here where we've got these big candles right in here in play. Well, we moved up sharply there and we moved down sharply there. We'll probably be looking at an area in here as a resistance level to the top side. Now that would be a nice relief rally if that were to occur, but I think that's all it would be, is a relief rally. So one of the things we're going to have to start doing is we're going to have to start watching these resistance levels as we rally back for that next potential place that we could fail. And obviously we could, you know, rally into that area right there and then again see those failures come into the market. But looking maybe for that little bit bigger rally to the upside. Remember, we are officially in a downtrend here on the diamonds until we can put in some kind of a higher low. And if we were to continue to sell this off and stretch this lower into this trend, remember, we're still in a bullish trend overall in the chart. This is just one of those examples of what happens when we push the markets too far, too fast. And then, boy, have we gotten a pile-on of bad data here in the market that is giving us some fits here overall. But remember, bigger part of this is the trend is still up. Now, I can't say the same is true when we start looking at the other indexes. The other indexes, like the SPY, we have broken our upside trend. And honestly, we did it in a pretty ugly way, breaking down in here some pretty ugly numbers, pushing us lower. You can see right here, if the bulls were to find inspiration, we're going to have to recover this area right in here. And I know everybody was probably thinking when I pointed this area out as the next level of price support, there's no way we're going to go all the way down there. There's no way we're going to go all the way down there. And then all of a sudden we did. So watching that closely, if the bulls find that inspiration, first we need to recover that area of support. And if we can do that, maybe up into here is where we look at that relief rally here in the market on that downtrend. Again, that's along that big bearish candle right in there where we might see a little bit of price resistance coming into play. We're going to need to recover that is what I'm saying more than anything if we're going to turn very, very bullish in the market. If the bears were to continue this exercise of pushing lower, well, doggone it, there's that next level of price support. So we'll want to be watching that. Obviously, we've given up the upside trend, and here also adding to that complication is we have given up our 50-day moving average here all of a sudden. Looking at this chart, you can see that our short-term moving averages are quickly coming down to cross or provide resistance on a technical basis for our SPY. So if we can find that bullish inspiration to start coming back up, once again, that area right in there is going to provide some resistance. If we take a look at our QQQ, NASDAQ, coming down pretty hard, and unfortunately this was a failure right here at price resistance, and you can see all of these areas coming together, kind of putting in that triple whammy of resistance, and my goodness, did it react negatively to that. Coming down here, testing this support level. If you guys remember, I had mentioned just a couple of days ago that nothing gets bad here in the QQQ unless we break that area right there. Holy smokes, when we broke it, it was important, and we pushed sharply lower here, testing this level of price support yesterday, and you can see in the pre-market we're actually pushing on down. So if the bears continue to press this lower, where's the next level of price support? Looks like we're looking down in here for that next level of price support. So if we can't catch some bullish action right off of this area in here, then look for that next level lower. If the bulls come in and start pushing back up here in the chart, well, remember, we've got several levels in here. We've got a level right here that we'll need to recover. And then as we push higher, we're going to have a level right here that we need to recover. That's right back at the top of that big ugly black candle yesterday. And we'll want to notice that as we push into that area right in here, fairly significant price resistance level, considering that we're going to add in this downtrend in that play as well. Let's take a look at our Russell. IWM, whew, talk about falling off a cliff here. When we broke through this trend to the downside, boy, things really accelerated here for the Russell, coming back hard and strong. And as you can see, breaking through this major support level in the chart is a relatively critical situation here for IWM. Now, looking at this stretch to the downside, you can see I had placed this line down here and say, well, that might be the next level of price support. We sliced right through that as well into the close, and we're stretching even a little lower here this morning. So now we have to look a bit lower. If the bears were to continue to push today, if they can find inspiration to keep going, the next level of price support is all the way down there, which would be pretty painful in that move. So fingers crossed that we can see some kind of a relief rally today. If we do, maybe a retest of that resistance right in there first. And if we can push back through there, we have that opportunity that we could come back up, maybe look here into this downtrend someplace and this big price resistance level in the chart for the next level of price resistance and the possible next opportunity to find some short trading. If we were to look at our VIX, our VIX has obviously confirmed the higher low in this chart, and it's what I've been suggesting, that the real selling would not occur in the market until we placed a higher low here on the VIX, and then that fear starts to come in. So we have now confirmed this new uptrend here in the VIX by breaking through that high point. We made a lower high and a higher high. That is the beginning of a trend, and you can see that right here. Now, saying that doesn't necessarily mean we're going to go straight up in this move. I don't see panic or terrible panic in the market just yet, but as we continue to hear about these weakening situations in China, certainly there is some concern. And of course, our financial situation is not a good situation at all. And seeing the trouble that our banks are having could add some additional pressure. But that being said, we're oversold in the short term. So what that means is we should be watching for some kind of bounce. If you're short, start tightening up those stop losses on the short side and start looking for that opportunity that we can get a little bit of a relief. That doesn't mean we zoom all the way back up, just that we catch some relief to the selling. It may actually set up the next wave of down move as we rally back. But watching this in here, maybe a little bit of rest or pullback is due now in that VIX. So watch that carefully. If we do see a little bit of relief rally starting to come in the market, this should pull back just a bit. Now let's take a look at our T2122. Our T2122 is obviously in the overbought situation, and I've warned on this. When we extend a market the way we did recently, where we just kept pushing and pushing and pushing to the upside like there was nothing wrong with our economy, well, when the selling starts, oftentimes we will push down and we will linger in this area as well. So we lingered up here for a while, we may linger down here for a while. That being said, being this oversold in the market, we do see that opportunity that a relief rally could begin at any time. So let's watch that closely for that. How we might see that is something I'll show you here in just a little bit. You can maybe gain a little bit of understanding of or confidence if you see some of these things begin to happen. But watch that carefully for that potential relief. It could begin at any time. If we take a look at our T2108, well, our T2108 continued to slip. 32% of our stocks holding above their 40-day moving average. This has been a massive change in sentiment in the market. And you can see we are potentially losing support right in here. If this support loses, well, you can see in the chart where we have that opportunity to go, we could come all the way back down here. So watch that closely. If we don't catch some price support here soon in this chart for that little relief rally, then this could get really ugly really, really fast. If we take a look at our T2107 doing the same thing, we were trying to hold on to this price support yesterday. Well, we gave that up pretty quickly yesterday afternoon, even though we did get a gap back up trying to catch a bounce, but I think that just punished a lot of folks that jumped in too soon into the market. Watching this, we've broken that support, and you'll notice we've got some more support under here. So hopefully we'll catch some support here with the percentage of stocks under the 200-day. We'll catch a bounce here maybe before too long. But just keep in mind, we've created a lot of resistance levels in this chart. So if we catch a relief, and start that bounce back up, then watch those resistance levels. It is possible we could fail right down through here and come right back to these levels if those bears really find that inspiration, particularly out of that ugly Chinese data. If we take a look at our T2101 has not shown us any relief yet. And I'm going to ask a question here and see if you guys could put an answer into the chat of the video, because I would like to know if I did a detailed video on why these indicators, these internal indicators, are so important and can really help you in your trading. If you guys are interested in that, let me know and I could do a detailed video on this, because I think this is very, very important to understand. So here in T2101, this is the absolute breadth index, and you can see right in here that the breadth of the market is continuing to expand on the sell side. We tried right in here for several days. We tried to continue to move to the upside, but we had no breadth here in the market pushing us forward. And it's that sell wave that all of a sudden brought the breadth into the market. And if you'll notice in here, we haven't even seen this turn yet. There's no turn, there's no hook, there's no indication just yet that we are done to the downside. So you'll want to watch this here pretty closely. As I mentioned yesterday, if we were to suddenly get a relief rally, what we want to see is this breadth continuing to expand. That would mean that all of a sudden the buy energy is really, really strong to push back here into the market. What I fear is that on the buy wave, we may see that buy wave tip over and see that breadth declining, which puts us in that situation when the sell wave comes back on, we could expand this even further. So that's where that panic will start to set in here in the market. So let me know if you'd like a little bit more detailed information on this in a video. Let's take a look at our economic calendar here today, and not a whole lot to talk about. We're going to have a quarterly services survey and the Baker Hughes rig count, which is probably nothing anybody's going to be paying much attention to at all. So nothing really there to find inspiration on the day. When it comes to the earnings calendar, well, we start looking at some stocks here that are notable. We've got BKE on that list. Now, BKE has already reported this morning. You can see a little bit of bearishness in that move, but buyers are trying to pick that up in the pre-market here again. John Deere has also reported this morning. It's holding in there pretty good. You can see we've got a bit of a problem in here where we've made a lower high and a lower low. So we are officially in a downtrend, and it doesn't look like that report is going to help us all that much in pushing back up. But I will say that there is some price support in this chart right in this area, so maybe that does help in providing a little bit of a relief rally there in that chart. Estee Lauder has also already reported. That's not looking so good here this morning, continuing to move lower, and VIPS isn't helping us out today either, already moving lower. The only notable that we have after the bell today would be Palo Alto. So keep an eye on that. And this is already in a downtrend and showing some failure here underneath its 50-day moving average, maybe headed toward its 200-day pretty quickly. It will kind of depend on how that earnings report comes out. So it's one of those situations where bad news just kind of continues to pile on. So how about we take a look at a few stocks that could be setting up for today? But before we do that, guys, I want to go back here and I want to take a look at a 15-minute chart. Now, you can use any time frame chart that you want to use in the market. And I want to point out something here that I think is really, really important for everyone to do. When we get these morning gap ups, particularly in a down move like this, we get these morning gap ups, take a look at a short-term chart. Use any time frame that you want, but you'll notice that gap up yesterday did nothing to recover the downtrend in that 15-minute chart. We gapped up to it, found resistance, and then we just continued to follow the downtrend here in the 15-minute chart. So I wanted to point that out, because if you start to see a relief rally coming in the market, or you get those gap ups and you get really excited about, hey, finally I can start buying up some stocks again, well, take a look at a short-term chart like that, and at least make the market show you that it can recover a short term, hold a higher low, and then then you can feel much more comfortable about jumping long into stocks. Be really, really careful when you see a pattern like this. We gap up, and I think it's just one of those things that the institutions use. If they can gap the market like that in the market, after a sell-off like this, they can trap a whole bunch of folks jumping in. What that really means is it gives them the opportunity to sell to the retail trader so they can lighten up their position. So watch that closely when we see those kind of moves like that. Make sure you have some metric in the market, whatever time frame that you want, that allows you to look at that chart and say, yeah, it's just not quite there yet. I got to be careful. I got to keep my hands in my pockets until we can at least get some kind of short-term trend moving to the upside. Let's take, and that doesn't mean, by the way, if we get a short-term trend moving to the upside that we're on a full reversal in the market. Not at all. It's just giving you that clue that, hey, there may be a little bit more safety in me trusting this long move here in the market. You still have to manage that trade very, very carefully, but just make sure that you can at least get something showing you a bullish trend in there before you start making those decisions to pile back into long positions. Let's take a look at some of these stocks that could be setting up. And remember, guys, these before we do that, if you guys could do me this quick favor, if this is the first time you've seen these videos, if you could please click that subscribe button on YouTube. Also click that bell icon when it pops up so you'll be notified every time I post a video. And if you find these videos to be worthy, do me that favor, click those thumbs up buttons, leave a brief comment. That helps the channel to continue to grow. I just want to say thank you to everyone who does take the time to do that. It truly means the world to me. Channel continues to grow. We have slowed down on the growth, but we're continuing to move up. We're getting closer to 30,500 subscribers, so thank you very, very much. Never would have imagined something that doesn't include a whole bunch of hyper drama, just looking at the charts and trying to figure out how things are setting up for the day, would get that kind of interest. So you guys are truly, truly awesome. Let's take a look at some of the stocks setting up. And remember, guys, these are not recommendations to buy or sell any security. Do your own due diligence. Make sure you're following your risk tolerances. Never, ever blindly follow anyone else's trade idea. So let's take a look at a few to the long side here. One of the things that we've been seeing in places in a material sector has been pretty strong, but all of a sudden we got a big shot of selling coming into the material sector. But I do like the way Lumber Liquidators could be setting up if it can hold this support in here. Big pop up here on that earnings report. Got a lot going on in here, as you can see in that chart. If I back this off, you'll notice that we've been moving in this long-term downtrend here. So if we can catch this break of this downtrend and it can hold a higher low in that chart, then there may be some opportunities coming into Lumber Liquidators. Keep an eye on that. But that being said, my goodness, we had some pretty ugly selling here in our builders yesterday. You can see big trends being broken in our builders pushing down. So I would watch stocks like Lennar now. Any bounce back up, notice that downtrend, any bounce back up in here could set up the next shorting opportunity in Lennar. And we're seeing that really take shape also in, whoops, not MSA. For some reason, I forgot the ticker, MAS, there it is. Senior moment, I guess. If you take a look right here on Masco breaking this trend, and you can see this pattern in here where we've created this pretty nasty looking head and shoulders. Boy, did we fall off the cliff yesterday in that chart. So what we're seeing here is some destruction beginning to happen and some worry that maybe things aren't as copacetic as we were hoping here in the building industry. Any rally back into this downtrend area I would be watching for that next possible short. And it is possible we could just continue to stretch on down here all at once before we catch that relief rally back to the upside. So we're seeing a lot of trouble starting to show up in those building sector stocks. Really came in hard yesterday. Take a look at some of our gambling sector stocks. Gambling sector is also feeling the pinch here of the declining consumer. We have quite an area in here of potential support in LVS. If that holds, we might be okay. You'll notice this little downtrend. We might catch a relief rally into that chart, but be really, really careful here, because this has that possibility of falling into a pretty deep hole here in LVS. And if we take a look at BKNG, that's not the one, DKNG, DraftKings, we're already starting into that failure here where we broke down through support, we broke down through trend, we rallied back to that resistance, and then those sellers came in pretty hard. I think we're going to seek this support level in here, and if we can hold in that support level, just look for some kind of relief rally back to test some resistance and downtrends, and we may actually continue that move to the downside. So watch that carefully here in the chart. You know, we had some interesting moves happening in the financials. We learned this week that, hey, our banks were not as in good a shape as all the talking heads were telling us they were, and we've started to push down. And as you guys remember from earlier this week, I suggested that XLF may come down here and test this area of the 50-day and 200-day moving average. Unfortunately, yesterday we went ahead and decided to fail through both of those. Now, what that tells me is we're getting a little bit stretched in that short-term move to the downside, and we may need a bit of a relief rally. But the situation that we have going on here in our banks will not resolve quickly unless we suddenly see the Federal Reserve start cutting rates and going back on the offensive here. And there is no sign, at least at this point, that they are willing to do that. So that being said, there is that possibility that our financials could continue to sink here. We've got a support area in that chart we may actually pursue right down in here on that. So watch that. And then any relief rally back up, I would be looking for that next opportunity to short until we see the Fed rolling over, because the situation here in the banks is not good, and what we're seeing out of China is adding more and more pressure to the financial institutions. So keep a close eye on that. So there's a few charts for you to think about, for you to watch. I want to wish you guys all a fantastic day. All obviously it's been a little bit of a painful week for everyone, but you know what? This is just the normal ebb and flow of the market. When we see a market stretch so far away from a trend, it's likely to come back and test that trend. And that's what we have. And unfortunately, the way the talking heads have been pitching this market, telling everybody that there's nothing wrong, everything is great, it's all up, that put a lot of folks into a painful situation here and probably seeing quite a bit of losses. So remember, everyone, look at the chart and look at the situation in the market itself. Look at some of those internals, what's really happening in here, so you can avoid that painful pullback. All the hype eventually comes back, and we're seeing some issues here in the market that could play into some tough times here for a period of time if things continue to worsen. So with that, everyone, I want to wish you all a wonderful day, a wonderful weekend, and I'll see you right back here bright and early Monday morning. Take care, everyone.